Hey, you guys are ready, go for it.
Hello, I'm Evan Mann, and my partner's at the Committee of Arctic Health, which we like to call the CAH, are Braden Meyer and Maura. Here at the CAH, all we want is for people to live happily and healthily. Recently, volcanologists have been seeing some fish as well. Apparently, there are some crucial active volcanoes underground and in the ocean. They could erupt any minute. The actual eruption shouldn't affect us, but they might cause a strange change in climate. According to the local volcanologists, if even one strange volcano erupts, the world will be split into three drastically different environments, and we will have to choose one of the environments to live in. One of the environments will be a huge desert. This would not be a good place to live at all. In the desert, water is extremely important. Think about this. You're incredibly thirsty after living 5 days in the desert. You think that you'll be fine since there is an oasis near to make your shelter. You go out to get some water, but everyone has hoarded it all, and you will eventually end up dying from the heat and thirst. There simply aren't enough resources in the desert for everyone. The next natural environment would be a huge ocean. If you want to live and very successfully in the ocean, you'll probably need gills. Modern humans don't have any practical limbs that can mutate into gills. Also, there are incredibly menacing creatures. More than 80% of the ocean remains unexplored, so we have no idea what types of predators can face our tiny human body. The last and best environment is the Arctic. Scientists have been studying the Arctic, so we know quite a lot about it. At the CAH, we all have come up with some great mutations that the human species can undergo to help live in the Arctic. First of all, we can turn our normal human hair into thick white fur. This fur can keep us warm at all times. Our fur will be white so that we can blend into the white snow and predators will not see us easily. We can also turn our ordinary arms into flippers. Who hasn't ever wanted to swim really fast? Yes, our fur will get wet and cold, but we don't need to be in the water for very long. Since we can swim really fast and we don't have to hunt for our food in the water, because of the next mutation I'm going to talk about. The ordinary human has ordinary stomach acid, right? Well, if we were to live in the Arctic, our stomach acid would not be so ordinary. We would prey on small land animals so that we don't have to hunt in the water, and we can digest raw meat because of the strong stomach acid. If you hire the CAH to decide the most beneficial environment for humans, we will not disappoint you, Mr. President.
Do you guys have any questions?